We are seeing the meanings for the divine names of Emperuman as described in Sri Vishnu Sahasranamam. We have seen the meanings up to 325th name. We will continue on now. 326th name, Apramattaha. Apramattaha means one who never loses enthusiasm in protecting his devotees. As we have seen, this series of names relate to Emperuman's incarnations. He incarnates as Narasimha, Varaha, Sri Rama, Krishna, and so on. And in each of those incarnations, he is focused on, mainly focused on protecting his devotees. So that particular aspect is highlighted in this name. 327th name is Pratishtitaha. Pratishtitaha means one who is established on himself. He doesn't need any other support. Even while incarnating, he manifests his own glories and he depends on no one else to acquire any particular strength or power. That particular aspect is explained here. Because especially in incarnations, we think sometimes that even Krishna went to Kailash. We heard this particular incident, to pray for a son from Shiva, from Rudra. But our Alvas and Acharyas have nicely explained this particular incident, that when Bhagavan goes to Rudra praying for a son, it is very funny because Rudra himself is the grandson of Bhagavan, because Rudra is the son of Brahma and Brahma is the first son of Lord Vishnu. So this is funny that a person goes to his own grandson and prays for offsprings. So it is a particular leela Bhagavan wanted to conduct at that particular time. So he does not depend on anyone else for his own abilities. He's got them all and he's standing on his own strength and does not require anyone else's support. This also have to be understood, that everyone else is supported by Bhagavan. Bhagavan is the substratum for everyone else to depend on. So that is what is explained in this particular name. Pratishtitaha, he is established on his own greatness. 328th name is Skandaha. Skandaha means one who destroys asuras and rakshasas, demoniac people. 329th name is Skandadaraha. That means he is the one who even protects and supports Skanda, who is Subramanya. Because Bhagavan himself says that among the commanders, I am Skanda in Bhagavad Gita. So when he says that, it means that he is the one who is supporting Skanda so that he can command the army of the Devas and win the battles for them. So unless one has the strength of Bhagavan, unless one is Antarya, one is having Bhagavan as Antaryami, one cannot do anything on their own. So here Skandadaraha means one who supports Skanda himself to be able to win over others. Next, 330th name is Duryaha. Duryaha means one who supports the whole world, which is a great burden. So, Bhagavan is the one who supports the entire creation on him. As Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita, just a fraction of his ability is sufficient to support the entire creation. So here, that particular aspect is explained that Bhagavan is the one who supports the entire creation. 331st name is Varadaha. Varadaha means, generally Varada means one who gives, one who grants boons. Here the context is that he is the one who is capable to grant boons and strength to devas, so that the devatas can conduct the universe. Each devata has particular responsibility, such as Indra is the lord of the three worlds, Bhuloka, Bhurloka and Suvarloka. Brahma is the overall in charge of all the universes, all the universe, that is all the worlds in that particular spherical universe. Varuna is the in charge for water, Vayu is the in charge for air, and so on. So each devata has their own responsibility and they have their own strength, and all of that is given by Bhagavan himself. So here Varada means one who gives the necessary strength to all the devatas. 332nd name, Vayu Vahanaha. Vayu Vahanaha means one who conducts Vayu, which is air, which is the life of everyone in this world. Nobody can sustain without air. And Bhagavan is the one who sustains air. So that is what is explained in this particular name, Vayu Vahanaha. Next, 333rd name, Vasudevaha. Vasudevaha means, it has two meanings, but here the pervasive nature, his omnipresence is explained. Vasudeva means son of Vasudeva, that is explained subsequently, but here it is in the context of Bhagavan being present everywhere and protecting everyone as a casual sport. For example, if Bhagavan needs to protect someone, he doesn't need to sweat too much. It is just a casual, effortless activity for him. That is what is explained here in this name, Vasudevaha, one who remains everywhere, one who is pervasive, and one who protects everyone by his presence. 334th name, Brihad Banuhu. Banu generally means sun, who gives light and who is radiant. Here, Brihad Banuhu means one who is vastly shining always, one who has got great glow, radiance, all of that. 335th name is Adidevaha. Adidevaha means one who is the cause for everything. And being that cause, he performs Srishti, Stiti and Samharam and so on, many other activities. That is explained in this name, Adidevaha. The next name, 336th name, is Purandaraha. Purandaraha means one who goes and destroys the towns of the demons. The asuras have their own abodes, their residences. Bhagavan goes and destroys them. As he went to Lanka and destroyed Lanka, where Ravana was present, he went to the town of Narakasura and destroyed that place. He went to the town of Banasura. He fought with Bana and many other, even devatas like Rudra, Durga, they all came along with Bana to fight with Krishna, and Krishna destroyed that town. And in this manner, Bhagavan destroys the towns of demoniac people. That is explained in this name, Purandaraha. The next name, Ashokaha. Ashokaha means, generally Shoka means sorrow. Ashokaha means, it could simply mean one who does not have any sorrow. But it doesn't stop there. It means that Bhagavan is the one who eliminates the sorrow of everyone else. The next name, 338th name, is Taranaha. Taranaha means one who helps us cross the abodes of fear. Each one may have certain aspects which scare us, and Bhagavan is the one who helps us cross over such spots, such aspects, such fearful aspects. Taraha. Taraha is specifically focused on Bhagavan's ability to help uplift everyone from this ocean of nescience, from this samsara. It is only Bhagavan who can help us relieved, freed from this ocean of samsara. Bhagavan himself says in many places in Bhagavad Gita, Daivi hayesha mamamayi gunamayi mamamaya gunamayi mameveye prapadyante maya metam tarantite. Only those who surrender unto me will be relieved from this ocean of samsara, he says himself. So that is what is explained here in this Taraha. 340th name is Shuraha. Shuraha means one who is valorous in defeating his enemies. Shaurihi. Shaurihi means, here Shauri means one who is the son of Shura. So in this context, Vasudeva is said to be a very valorous person. So Bhagavan, being the son of Vasudeva, is explained here as he is the son of Shura, who is Vasudeva. So Shauri means one who is son of Shura. So here Vasudeva is explained as Shura, and Bhagavan being the son of Vasudeva is explained here. 342nd name is Janeshwaraha. Janeshwaraha means one who is the Lord for everyone who is born. So anyone who is born, there must be somebody who is controlling that person. And Bhagavan is that controller who controls everyone. So he is the Ishvara for everyone. That is explained in this name, Janeshwaraha. 343rd name, Anukulaha. Anukulaha means one who is favorable, one who is adaptive. Here, Bhagavan is supreme. He has Paratva. He has greatness of being in Paramapadam, Sri Vaikuntham, being the Lord of the Nityasuris, Muktas, and all that. Yet, when he incarnates as Rama or Krishna or Varaha or Narasimha, he is helping his devotees. As Krishna, he was even obedient and submissive towards the gopikas and the gopas, the cowherd girls and boys. That is his quality, which is explained in this name, Anukulaha. 344th name is Shatavartaha. Shatavartaha means one who has great wealth, opulence, which greatly spins around and which increases manifold constantly. So his opulence is explained here as Shatavartaha, that is his glowing opulence. Next, 345, Padmi. Padmi means, Padma means lotus. Padmi means one who has lotus. So here it is meaning that Bhagavan is having a lotus as his plaything, as his play toy, on his hand always. That is explained in this name, Padmi. 346th name is Padma Nibekshanaha. Padma Nibekshanaha means Akshana. Aksha means eyes. So here he is having lotus flower like eyes, especially very well blossomed lotus flower like eyes, divine eyes. That is explained in this name, Padma Nibekshana. He has his name, Pundarikaksha. Everyone knows that. He is lotus-eyed. And this Pundarikakshatva is one of the identity of the Supreme Lord. So that is explained here, Padma Nibekshanaha. Next, 347th name is Padmanabha. Padmanabha means one who has lotus-like navel or having lotus on his or in his navel. Both are explained in this particular name. As he is lying down, reclining in the Shirarnava, milk ocean, he has the lotus flower on his navel, and that is where Brahma appears, or Brahma takes birth, and that is all to be remembered here. 348th name, Aravindakshaha. Aravindakshaha. Aravinda again means lotus, Aksha again means eyes. So here, one who is having lotus-like divine eyes, that is explained in this name, Aravindakshaha. 349th name, Padma Garbha. Padma Garbha means Upasakas. These are the Bhakti Yoga Nishtas, those who meditate and perform Dhyanam. And such people, they have the lotus heart. Usually the heart is explained to be a lotus. And these yogis are people who are doing Dhyanam. They have Bhagavan in their heart, which is like a lotus. So that is explained in this particular name, Padmagarbha. One who is being meditated upon in their hearts. 350th name is Sharira Bhrithu. Sharira Bhrithu means one who is, again, continuing from the previous name. Bhagavan is in the heart of the Upasakas, those who perform Bhakti Yoga or meditation. And while being there, he is accepting all the worship. And he is nurturing all that worship of such yogis. That is explained in this name, Sharira Bhrithu. He is remaining in the heart of the yogis and the Upasakas and nurturing their worship and nurturing their devotion. That is explained in this name, Sharira Bhrithu. With this, we will stop today and we'll continue in the next class. ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜியர் திருவடிகளை சரணம் பராசர பட்டர் திருவடிகளை சரணம்.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, KOYIL app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, KOYIL.org.